stretching the black apple trash claws. Vicious when attacking, all days we spent relaxing. Now he's poised for action. Slides up the cat door, pauses momentarily to survey his surroundings. Then smack four paws, hit the ground off and running. His back to the sun as he heads in a south-southeasterly direction. Head of urban inspection of his territory. It's a nightly story which gets gory if it has to. He passes through the alley, senses heightened, and it becomes apparent that he's writing his suspicions. Viciously lying in the shadow spots, the fat foes lurking. Feline jerks who he got beef with. This ain't Garfield and Heathcliff, but crouching killers reminiscent of Bagheera from the Jungle Book they meet with. Watch melee closet, she shine in the moon's rays, ready for play. He's afraid but prepared to slay adversaries necessarily if they can't be coerced to move from his way. So he pounces, he pounces. Black cat leaps, spitting an instant, flips in midair, grabs a shabby tabby by the throat, cuts him ear to ear, the bigger scabby lands. But wait, where is that saga? Means everything's quiet, too quiet, he freezes and sniffs the air, the hairs on his nape bristle. But then, from the corner of his ear, he hears a whistle, and in a second's fraction, with a flurry of action, the cat's upon the back attacking, his spine starts relaxing. When he feels the traction of the claws enter his flesh, no energy left, so he flips into life. Number seven takes a breath to recover, then rolls over, shoots his left paw high, directly to the saga piece's right eye. Who surprised flies back blind and rewinds his tracks with the tabby back out the alley. Victorious, the black cat sits and licks his wounds, that is, till he sniffs that poo and he's out. Waves of vapors with the unmistakable scent of feline bush push up all around the black cat. Envelop him, hypnotize him, intoxicate him till he falls flat on his back upon the ground, rolling, tongue lolling. All he can seem to think of is hitting that hole and wailing he conveys that sentiment. And then amidst his ruckus, he hears a hesitant mute in response, it's affirmative. So he picks himself up off the ground, cause he yearns to give this she-cat a piece of himself, not his mind, mind you. He peeks around the bush, not knowing what he'll find, and boom, there in the moonlight lies a tight white long hair who does not belong there. What's a girl like you doing in a place like this? He just replies with a sensual hiss and a swish of that soft fur into his face. So he wastes no time, takes his place behind that behind and unwinds. It's sublime, soon as she casts squealing, he's feeling pumped up, the spunky humps of vigor till they both keel over in relief. Kisses the white cat on the cheek and then he leaves her, lying behind the bush as he gets on his way. The sun's rays warm, his face is clear that the day is approaching. The black cat quickens his stride, homeward bound, where he'll sleep till the next night.